The sights and sounds of a parent trying to get her kid off a Denver school bus. Now that mom faces charges for assaulting the school bus driver.
Both parents and the school district say there is a lot more to what happened. Denver Public Schools and Denver Police are now investigating. The school bus driver and another employee are on paid leave.
And 9 News reporter Nelson Garcia joins us now to tell us what led up to all this. And Nelson, by all accounts, this escalated quickly.
That's right, Kim, Kyle. On Wednesday, the school bus left the Northfield Denver Green School on its way to make the usual drop-offs. When DPS says the driver had to stop the bus twice because the students were becoming too unruly. The second time it stopped, it was near where parents were waiting for their kids, and that's when the situation got worse.
From the video shot by a mom, the kids inside can be heard, some of them screaming for their parents. The bus had been stopped for about 30 minutes on Kearney Street, just outside of another school, near where parents were waiting for their kids. Parent Janelle Williams says her son was not sure why the driver had to stop.
He didn't really understand exactly why the bus stopped. The commotion that was on the bus, it seemed to be maybe a rowdy child, something that happens on buses all the time. So he didn't even understand why the bus was parked and, you know, why the driver was refusing to move.
DPS says the bus driver and a paraprofessional on board were waiting for security to arrive when parents started demanding that their kids be let off the bus.
When you watch that video, that's tough to watch. I understand the frustration parents are having.
Deputy Superintendent Mark Ferrandino says the district has a procedure for reunification in this situation. But things were getting heated.
It might have been a different way to look at how you handled that situation and just being able to let those kids out to be reunified with those parents.
One mom got tired of waiting. On the video, you can see Brandy Martin board the bus, and that's when the scuffle started. You can see things go back and forth with the driver pulling her hair and Martin throwing punches, hitting him in the face. Williams says her son witnessed one of the DPS employees touching a female student inappropriately, but she did not want to go into detail.
But he did say that he did witness an unfortunate incident to where it did make him yell at the particular person to say, hey, don't touch her like that. What are you doing?
Ferrandino says that's all under investigation.
We also spent time today looking at videos from the cameras that were inside the bus to understand what happened in that situation. And it's clear that was not handled to the expectations we have.
Brandy Martin was arrested by Denver police for assault. Ferrandino says both DPS employees had to go to the hospital for their injuries. Brandy Martin put out a statement online that said she's thankful for all the support and for the families who are sharing her story. Kyle?
Yeah. Something tells me we are just beginning to find out what led up to that and then what happened in that moment.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, thank you, Nelson.
You're welcome.
Yeah.